Listen for the words faculty and expect.
It's another early morning. Excuse me.
And Becky and Bob are getting a lift to school. They usually walk.
Becky, you're probably wondering why I'm driving you to school today.
Actually, I hadn't really...
I have a surprise! And I cannot tell you, okay? I'll tell you. Bum-ba-da-ba-bum-bum-bum! You're in the car with a new, official, substitute teacher from Miss Davis's class.
My teacher, Miss Davis?
Yep. She came down with a particularly pesky case of chicken pox, and after what I understood to be a very thorough 10-minute search, the principal gave me a call. Do you believe it, Becky? I'm a teacher.
So you're my new teacher?
Yes, I'm part of the faculty. Starting now! Becky, get to class! Kidding.
Yes, I see what you did there.
Wait, is that the time? Becky, get to class! And me too! Good morning, class. I am your substitute teacher, Mr. Botsford. Botsford. I'll write it on the board later. Pop quiz, Becky. Get it, Becky? I'm your pop, and I'm giving you a quiz. Pop quiz.
Yes, I get it.
Good one, Mr. Botsford.
Dad? Oh, I mean, Mr. Dadford? No, Mr. Bot's dad. I mean, Mr. Botsford.
Woo! Maybe you'll do better next time.
Oh.
Okay. And now, let the learning begin. 10. 11. Exercise. Pop quiz scoops.
Yes, Mr. Botsford?
Healthy bodies equal what?
Healthy minds?
Well done, scoops. A plus. Your reward? 5. More knee bends.
Ha! Your dad's hilarious. Don't you love having him as our teacher?
Yeah, well, I think he's doing okay.
Becky! Let's cut down on the chatter, okay? I expect less talking and more knee bending. Hee-yah!
Oh. Hi, Hank. Want a little scratch? You like a little scratchy scratch?
Now, Becky, let someone else pet Hank. Don't go hogging the guinea pig.
Hog the guinea pig. Funny.
That was a pop quiz joke, Scoops. A plus. Great job.
Thanks, Mr. Botsford.
Hog the pig.
Seriously, though, Becky, don't hog the guinea pig. This hat is a clue. Quick, pop hat quiz. Where's Saskatchewan? Becky, I know you know this.
Yes, I know it. It's,
Too long. Scoops.
Canada.
Nice!
No.
Woo!
Well, Becky, you can expect to spend the weekend reviewing these flashcards. So long story short, a mystical elf in a flannel jumpsuit has nothing to do with why rhombuses have four sides of equal length. Kyle, I hope that answers your question. Oh, that's all the time we've got. Okay, goodbye, mathematicians. I'm so happy to be a new addition to your classroom.
Another winner, Mr. Botsford.
Okay.
Mr. Botsford?
You know what? Close enough.
Dad?
Not right now, Becky. I have a lot of work to do.
Right, but school's over, so are we leaving soon?
Oh, I expect to be here a while. So you and Bob should, just walk home.
Oh, well, okay. Bye.
Later on the walk home.
Wow, so Dad seemed kind of different today, huh? It was almost like I was just another kid in the class. Except he was nicer to them than he was to me. I mean, not right now, Becky. He's never said that to me. Time to do what I do best. Because no one ever says, not right now, word girl. Word!
Boy, you're a real pro at that. You sure you never done this before?
Actually, I do this 3 times a week, at least.
Come on, come on! We gotta hurry before Word Girl!
Stop right there, Butcher! And Kid Potato, how are you, sir?
Well, nice to see you.
Oh, man, I knew it!
Really? The big bad butcher is scared of a little girl and a pet koala?
But Pop!
Damn, but Pop me. You don't see any of these other nice people getting all worked up over Miss Red Pajamas over there?
Hey!
That's because they're not the ones committing a crime!
Always with the excuses.
Huggy is a monkey, and these aren't pajamas!
Okay.
And you should try to be a little nicer to your son.
But he keeps doing everything wrong.
Oh, come on. He's not doing everything wrong.
My bad.
You were saying?
Do you expect expect your son to be perfect all the time?
Yeah, do you expect me to be perfect all the time?
Actually, the word is expect. It means to anticipate, watch for, or look for something. If your father, Kid Potato, expected there could be a mistake, he could prepare for it instead of blaming you.
Oh.
And how does he expect you to do a good job if he's picking on you?
Yeah!
And he should not expect you to be completely quiet when you're doing knee bends!
Yeah!
Huh?
I mean, someone asks you a question, you answer it, right? Even if it is during gym class.
For some reason, I don't think we're talking about me anymore.
Oh, sorry. My dad is my new teacher at school.
Whoa.
Whoa.
I know, right? It's just weird. He's nicer to my friends than he is to me. I have to call him Mr. Bot, Mr. his last name. It's just, ugh.
Wow, word girl. Seems like you got a lot of stuff on your mind.
Yeah.
Well, here's some more stuff to go on your mind. Pastrami attack!
Yeah!
Pastrami, on your mind. Get it?
Good one.
Hey, you forgot the furry thing. Potato pie pow!
Should I,
Let's get in the car.
The next day...
You know, I don't like when the butcher robs banks, but I can't believe the way Kid Potato treats his son. Always criticizing him, picking on him in front of the whole class.
Class?
And he didn't even give me a ride to school today. Oh, no, not Kid Potato, my dad. Can you believe we have to walk to school? I know we usually walk. That's not the point. Oh, man, not again.
Can't quite get the angle.
We get a great space in front of the store we're gonna rob, and you can't park.
I know I can't let them rob the store, but if we stop them, I'll be late for school. Yes, I know what to do.
Great. Now I'm all car sick.
Well, if you just stop complaining and let me park...
You can start complaining when I park you in jail!
Nice one!
Thank you.
So how's the whole teacher-dad thing working out?
No. You're not going to distract me again. Yeah, my dad's on the faculty at school, so what?
Whoa, I never said anything about your dad on a factory.
Not a factory, a faculty. A faculty is another name for the group of teachers at school.
Oh! Just think, if a factory made teachers, it would be a faculty factory, huh?
Hey, kid, what do you call an entire group of potatoes?
I don't know. What do you call it?
A getaway! Butter-Rooney's platoon! You got stopped from doing a crime before you even got in the store. That's got to be some kind of a record.
Just leave it alone, Pop.
Well, Becky Botsford, nice of you to join us. Please take your seat.
Oh.
And remember, everyone, tomorrow is Dads and Donuts Day. We'll greet and eat. All dads are invited to stop by and enjoy a cinnamon bun with me. Becky, please see me after class.
Yes, Mr. Botsford?
You seem a little down today. Is everything okay?
Yeah. I kind of feel like you're picking on me.
What? Becky?
Like you expect me to be perfect, and when I make a mistake, you...
What, I tell you that you're wrong?
Well, yeah.
Now, Pumpkin, I don't think I should go easy on you just because you're my daughter.
I don't want you to. Too much. Maybe just a little.
But, Becky, the reason I'm so hard on you is because I know you're good enough and smart enough to handle it. Maybe I need to remind you of that more often.
Thanks, Dad.
I want you to know that I'm sometimes your teacher, but I'm always your dad. Now, what do you say we seal this deal with an official Botsford hug?
Give me the wheel! Give me the wheel!
Robbery at the jewelry store? Dad, Bob and I are really enjoying our walks home, so we're going to leave now and let you get back to work.
Okay. Oh, and Becky, don't tell anyone, but you're my number one favorite mathematician.
Ah, thanks, Mr. Dadford.
Come on, hurry up and park. There's still time left on that meter.
Correction, your time's up.
Meh.
Yeah, not my best.
Florence, sonny.
Uh-oh.
You know, Butcher, I learned something today. I learned that, yes, sometimes your dad can be hard on you, and he may expect a lot more from you than he does other people, but that's only because he thinks you're really great.
My son.
Come here, Bob. Come in for the big one. Come here. Nope. Oh. You know, this is great, Pop. But we really gotta remember, get away first, then hug.
You can't fight your emotions, son.
And so, on Dads and Donuts Day, the newest member of the faculty, Mr. Botsford, was both Becky's dad and her teacher. And they knew exactly what to expect from each other so they'd never be confused again. Next time, grab your dad or a donut or both and drive over to join us for another emotional and always pop-quizzical episode of Word Girl.